Now, when we come to verse 9, the visions are over now, and we come back to that which actually takes place. Now, again, let's recall that Zechariah, along with Haggai, is prophesying to the remnant that have returned to this land. Now, I'm reading verse 9. The word of the Lord came unto me, saying, take of them of the captivity, even Heldai, and Tobijah, and of Jediah, who are come from Babylon, and come the same day, and go into the house of Josiah, the son of Zephaniah. Now, we are given here three men that have returned from Babylon. They did not come back with either of the groups that returned, but they have now come on their own. Now, Heldai means robust, and Tobijah means God's goodness, and Jediah means God knows. Now, you can tie those together if you want to with, I think, a very definite meaning that God knows that through his goodness that he intends to put his king upon the throne down here, and he's going to do it in a robust and powerful manner. And what takes place now is a symbolic crowning, but it pictures the coming of Christ and his reign upon this earth, that which is yet future. And we have that given to us. And I'd like to read on into this chapter. Verse 11, then take silver and gold and make crowns and set them upon the head of Joshua, the son of Jozadak, the high priest. Now the Lord Jesus is the great high priest today. The book of Hebrews is a book that speaks of the fact that Christ is our great high priest. And we're told to consider our great high priest, the Lord Jesus Christ. Now today, he's passed within the veil. He's gone into heaven, and he's sitting at God's right hand. But he's waiting until the time comes when his enemies are made his footstool, and he'll come forth to this earth to establish his kingdom here upon this earth. Now, what we have here is a picture of that. And you'll notice that all of this follows in sequence. After the judgment of God's people, after the judgment of all the Gentile nations of the world, now we have the coming of Christ and his crowning as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And that's the explanation of why we have all these crowns here. He is the King of Kings, and all will cast their crowns before him. He is the one who is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And so Joshua here, as the high priest of that day, represents the Lord Jesus. We have actually the threefold ministry of the Lord Jesus given in time span. The first time span is that he came to this earth 1900 years ago as God's prophet. He came down here to speak for God as God's word, and he himself was the Word of God, for he revealed God in humanity and revealed the love of God by going and dying upon the cross for your sins and my sins, so that he's God's prophet. Now today, he's God's priest, and he's at God's right hand. He's entered into the Holy of Holies, God's presence itself. He's presented his own blood for your sins and my sins, and he ever lives there to make intercession for us. He also intervenes for us when there's sin in our lives, and we confess that sin. He also walks among the lampstands. Now, one day, he's coming out again, and when he comes out, he's coming, as the book of Revelation makes it very clear, as King of kings and Lord of lords, so that he's prophet, priest, and king. And so here Joshua is crowned because he is the high priest.